Hi everyone, and welcome back to this Let's Play of Morse Online. This is my gaming connoisseur, and this is the beginning of the third era. Alright, so I'm just logged into the game for the first time. I downloaded the game via torrent, and I do have to say that I'm very happy with the results this time round. There wasn't that many as many bugs as last time, especially with the launcher. I only had to basically reset all the options once, well actually twice, but the second time round I think the settings have stayed, because usually what happened in the past was that once I put the settings, then I launched the game, then somehow the settings would just default to something else, something that's really different, and I have to go back and set everything back. So, but this time around I think the bugs have been, well, at least from what I can see so far, the bugs are relatively minimal, and so it's not too bad. I do find that the SV has done a better job this time, and so far there's no so far there doesn't appear to be any bugs yet. Okay, let's see how combat works. Okay, new animations for the undead. Right. Oh man. Okay, so yeah, I was gonna parry, but I just wanted to kill that thing as quickly as possible. Now I want to get to that bridge, because I've had a look at the Mortal Online Twitch, Mortal Online Twitch, and there's a lot of players at the bridge area, so I just want to actually, maybe I'll just rest a little bit. And once again, my I have to reset all my user interface, all the buttons, but I'll do that later. Yeah, I just want to do my first impressions and get to the bridge, because I think there are a lot of players who are there and either building the bridge or trying to stop it from being built. And I do think that the I might have to adjust the sound, so yeah. Alright, let's put this to 30, actually maybe 40 would be better. Ambient volume, I'll put that to 40 as well. We'll put everything to 40. Now, just to say that the new preferences screen is also much better. It's a lot more straightforward and streamlined. Okay. Cool. Meet my first player for in this new expansion. Yeah, I think he's heading to the bridge, so I'll okay. Hopefully I don't get killed on this, my first episode of the third era. Oh man, Night Snatchers, okay. I think they're going after that player, so maybe I'll just wait for the... Okay, how about if I... Okay, so the bridge doesn't appear to be built as yet. Although I'm pretty sure at some point, you know, it'll be fully built. Falling damage. So let's have a look at my... Oh, look at this. It's very bright. Okay. That's okay with me. I'm not too fast. And it seems like SV has fixed the health numbers. If you look at my health bar and the numbers under it, well, actually in the middle of it, before the expansion, you know, sometimes the health points would be the same as the mana points, and that was a bug. So it didn't show the correct hit points in numbers, but it seems that with the expansion they fixed that bug. So well done to SV for that. And I hope that swimming isn't broken. Yeah, swimming would really come in handy, so if you're a new player, consider taking up swimming. Oh, uh-oh. Red players. Okay. Hopefully no one's out here to kill me. Alright. Okay, so... Wow. Look at this. Everyone's working to build the bridge. Wow, this is really cool. Okay, so can I... Okay. So can I construct? Ah, okay. Wiggly tough. Oops. Yeah. I know that there are a number of guilds that would like me to, you know, inviting me to join their guild. And you know, I am thinking about joining a guild, but you know, it's just for now. I just feel that I would like to, you know, just go solo. Yeah, so like I said in my previous episode, which was the closing episode for the second era, I said that, you know, I signed up for, you know, to be part of this, global construction project. I think, you know, a lot of players have signed up to be part of this. So basically, there's a building agreement that's been posted on the forums, and so basically, you know, any players that want to be part of this, be in this area and declare themselves as peaceful, then they can sign up with the person who posted that forum. They can tell them their name, their character name, and they will be added to that list. And so basically that allows you to be here. And so I'll be here just defending the construction effort. Now, I have forgotten to bring, my reagents. Oh, what's going on? Okay, kill Herge. So I'm going to be here to defend the bridge construction effort, so basically if you sign up with on that list, then you won't be killed. So if you want to be part of this, then check out the link at the description below that takes you to the post on the official forums. Hermann Göring. Okay. So I'll probably stay at the bridge, or I can... So I probably have to watch out for that player, Herge. Okay. Alright, so that player is killing defenders, so I might try and do my part. Come to defend, yep. Alright, so far there's not that many bugs I can see, but I think the quick action to reply has is a bit bugged, I think, because now I have to press enter and then press slash and then R to reply. But I'm sure SV will fix that at some point. So far so good. There's not that many bugs I can see. So I think SV has definitely stepped up their game. I think, you know, some players might disagree, but from what I can see from my experience so far, the bugs have been relatively minimal compared to last time. Says, let's see who's here. Yeah, there's a lot of builders. Oh, how did that guy get over there? Well, I wonder how that guy manage to get to the other side, because there's a huge gap here. Or maybe he jumped on this and then just walked across, so... Yeah, I'm so glad that I'm back to playing this game, because yeah, and I'm glad that I could get back into it so quickly. So for those of you who have not, you know, patched up, I would recommend that you download the torrent file and download the patch. Download the entire client via torrent and install it using the advanced installation method. Now, if you don't know, how to do that, I put a description in the link. put a link in the description below to a forum link to a forum post by one of the GMs, I think, and that will teach you how to do it, how to do an advanced install. So. Because from what I've seen from the forum so far, a lot of players, they're having very slow download speeds via the patching via the launcher. Okay. And so right now I put everything, all the settings on high. So everything's on high at the moment and running at 1366 by 768. And the frame rate is holding steady at 30, and that's because I'm using fraps. But if I turn off fraps, I think the frame rates would be, you know, would be much higher. Now, I do wonder how long it's going to take for the bridge to be finished, finished construction. But this is what I signed up for, so I'm going to be here. I'm going to be here for quite some time. And so if I have to, I'll cut back to when, you know. So I might break this into multiple episodes. You recording boss. See? Yes. Fish pig. He's asking me whether I'm recording. Spared your life yesterday. You might have the wrong person. Okay, so this is the first time I've seen so many players, red, grey, and blue, all working in Unity, and it's really great to see, because the game, you know, the player base in this game is, you know, relatively smaller than a lot of popular MMORPGs out there, like, you know, Elder Scrolls Online or World of Warcraft, but you know, this is the first time I've seen so many players. You know, murderers, criminals, and, you know, innocent players or working together instead of killing each other. Okay, so I think what I'll do is I'll break this into multiple episodes. So I'll cut back when there's more progress, then I will cut back, and then we'll continue, and then we'll see how we go. You know, so hopefully we can cross this bridge. Although I'm kind of thinking that it's going to take a long, long time. So we'll see how we go. I think what I might do is I'll go back to my bank so I can grab some reagents and a torch and some other stuff. Oh whoa. Don't wanna fall. Yeah, since there's a lot of, you know, the construction is still well underway and it's probably gonna take, you know, quite some time. I thought I might go back. Let's go back and grab some stuff. And I have noticed some bugs already in the key bindings menu in the, you know, in the options. Some of the key bindings are a bit bugged, so that's already something that I noticed, which is buggy. Oh, nice snatch. Okay, I've got to be careful because from what I see in the patch notes, the mobs will now aggro you. They will aggro you regardless of whether they're, you know, because some mobs back before the expansion, you know, some mobs would aggro you while others won't. But now all of them will aggro, so it's going to be a lot harder for travelers to get around. Oops. almost ran into a bunch of them. Okay. I might try and Yeah, hopefully I'll make it back to Medulli without getting killed. So just now when I turned off Fraps, the frame rate was holding at 45 frames per second, so I think that's not too bad. Okay, so let's hope that we can make it back. Chunks. Oh, okay. There's a mob after me. Safe. Yeah, so as you can, I'm not sure whether that was a Belbus or a Night Snatch. Most likely it's Belbus, so it does appear that Belbus is now attack. So those of you who, you know, are going to and from Medulli and the bridge area, you know, beware. Okay, so we safely made it back, and I'm out of stamina. Let's get back into the range of the guards. Town's empty. That's because I think everyone's at the bridge area, hard at work. So, yeah, Medulli's practically deserted. Yeah, so. Oh, there's a player. Okay, so let's put some of our stuff back on the maybe I can buy a pickaxe, so that I can help out with the construction effort. Wait, I'll put some reagents here in my inventory. Some food as well. Actually, maybe I'll take an extra 10. sulfur. Or should I s- oh. Wrong amount. Nitre, I should say. Alright, let's go get that pickaxe. That pickaxes can repair, you know, repair the bridge. Alright, let's go back to the bridge. It's night time at the moment, so, you know, but I do have to say that I think the graphics does seem to look a little bit better now at night time compared to before. Okay, so now I'm properly well equipped now. Or better equipped, I should say. That's nitre, calamine, sulfur, and water. Yeah, this is, every time you cross this area, you always got to be on the lookout for, you know, player killers. Yeah, I think that's the Belbus that was chasing me. So maybe it's probably better if I go this way. Yeah, this is probably a safer way, so I think in future, yes, this is probably a better way to get to the bridge, although on the downside it is a very narrow pass, so if you run into player killers, then you pretty much have no option but to fight it out. Just turn around every now and then just to check. You never know. Seadew. Yeah, there's a lot of pickables in this in the game world, so, you know, and quite a lot of them I have no idea what they're used for, but you know, but you know, I'm sure there's a lot of, you know, plants that you can pick, and their properties are probably not immediately known to you, but Okay, am I gonna sink? Hopefully not. I'm not sure why there's no music, because normally here you would be, you know, I would hear music, but for some reason the music is not playing. And maybe it's a bug, or maybe there's an option that I've not enabled, who knows. I just noticed in the Dooley Town Crier. Yeah, I think the Dooley Town Crier is a bit bugged as well. Is, you know, if you look at the chat, it says has lost control of Pash, has lost control of Belrim. So that doesn't make any sense. Okay, I think I know why I was sinking earlier on in episode 1 of the third era, because I was carrying that Walking Dead carcass, and that thing weighs a lot more than everything that I'm carrying right now put together, so that's probably the reason why I'm sinking. But as you saw just now, I'm not sinking at all, so... Alright, so... So let me help out with the construction effort. Okay, so let me try putting the... Okay, let me just take note of what I've got. Okay, so even the Rizar will someday know the truth of Soldius. Oh, this is really cool. I'm helping out with the... Oh, I'll learn a new skill. Okay. I'll probably just disable that because, you know, I don't have that many resource points left. Alright, so thank you for watching this episode, and so I will cut back. This is likely going to be a very long, you know, multi-part series of episodes to start off the new era, the third era, and so if you could please like, comment, subscribe, and share. Thank you for watching. This is Fine Gaming Connoisseur. Take care. Hi everyone, and welcome back to this Let's Play of Mods Online, the Third Era. This is Fine Gaming Connoisseur here, and today you're watching episode 3. Okay, so I've logged off for about a day or so, and now that I'm back, it seems like the bridge has been built, repaired. And so it looks like now I should be able to go to Sarducaa. Uh-oh. Oh, thought that guy was gonna attack me, seeing he's a. So yeah, I still have all my supplies, and. Okay, so what have I got? Yeah, so pretty much, all the stuff that I was carrying before. At the end of the last episode. Alright, so let's see where this bridge goes to. I mean, how far it takes. How far it takes to get to Sarducaa. I'm guessing it's going to be a very long walk. And so... well, this is a very long bridge. And what is happening? Is this some sort of a loading screen or something? Okay, well my solid state drive is doing something, so maybe it's loading the area. Okay, so the game hasn't crashed, thank goodness. Alright, and there is, and as you know, in the new expansion there is the heat system introduced, so... And why can't I do anything? Okay, I hear some music. Okay. Alright. Wow. Wow, look at this. New skyscape. Look at the sky. Man, I wish Marlin could be like this. Okay. So this is my first time coming up here, coming into this new continent. Very excited. At the same time, also, a little bit uncertain of what I'm going to find. So, like I did in Marlin, I'm going to take all the proper precautions. Wow, this definitely looks very nice. So I do have to give a thumbs up to SV for all the hard work that they did. I mean, this continent looks much, much better, in my opinion, compared to... Yeah, I think the landscape does look a lot better. And there's a bug there, you know the... It shouldn't be like this. I mean, you've got half the moon clipped off, and you've got this. You've got this. You know. Yeah. So that definitely doesn't look too good. So that's something that SV probably needs to fix. But you know, bugs aside, I think I will enjoy this very much. Can I pick this? Aloe vera? Okay. Okay, I've not seen this before. Ah, okay, so it gives mana nourishment. Well, that's good. It's the first plant that I've picked in the new continent. Okay, while I'm at it, I might just increase the volume a little bit. So, actually, never mind. Because I get the feeling that if I change the settings in the preferences, it's gonna mess up my graphics settings later on. So rather than having it happen, you know, rather than doing that while I'm recording, I'll do it. You know, I'll change the settings when I'm not recording. Alright. Wow, this is definitely very interesting. So even though not all the bugs have been fixed, but I think it's still a very good effort on SV's part. I mean, given that they're a small team and you know, with all the limitations that brings, I think that they could pull this off, you know, in a relatively, you know, they were able to do this relatively smoothly, and by that I don't mean that they, you know, did 100% perfect, but for the effort, for compared to before, compared to the last expansion, you know, the last time when they brought out 1.8x, I think this is a much better effort. And what is this? This might be a dungeon. I think this is a mine. Mine shaft, maybe? Yep, definitely a dungeon. Okay, I think I definitely need my torch now. And so, there's someone beeping outside, pressing their horn. Barrel, huh? Okay. Ooh, nice. Oh, this is cool. Finding loot in the dungeon. Yep, I definitely like this. Chest! Where is it? Huh? Where is it? Where's the chest? Ah, there it is. Oh, this is... I'm definitely having fun, guys. Definitely... Oh, it's locked. Can I bash it open? No. SV, if you can, in future, if you can introduce a bashing mechanic, you can bash open chests if you don't have the key. I think that'd be nice. But I'm pretty happy. I'm pretty happy with just some silver coins and cuprum. Wow, this is very, I'm definitely enjoying this. Okay, so before I go any further, I'll just eat some food. So I think I'm starting to get hungry, so... Okay, my first dungeon in Sarducaa. Oh, lot of flingers. Okay, these mobs aggro now, so... So I probably won't be able to take them on. Can't see anything. Alright, I think it's not gonna work. It's not gonna be it's not gonna be good for me. I mean, this is, if I go any further, it's probably just gonna lead to my death. I mean, of course I can just wander in with my torch and everything, but I think if I'm gonna explore this dungeon, I'm gonna need help, so yeah, I'll probably just I'll come back here again next time, but now that I know there's a dungeon here, I can always come back. But for now, this is probably... Oh, no, that's not how I want it. Yeah, that's better. Alright, so this is, well, I'm gonna really gonna be exploring this land at length, and so I guess maybe I'll just find a safe place, because this isn't exactly a safe place to be. I mean, right outside the dungeon, you know, it's just there's likely gonna be people coming to this place. I guess another thing that I'll do is I'll check my heat, the temperature. Oops. Okay, so here you go, that's the new system, body heat and temperature. If above zero you are too hot, if under zero you are freezing. Oh, okay. Alright, so I guess that means I need to... Oh, okay. And I did read on the somewhere that Caladians, they don't have any heat resistance. So... Alright, so I'm gonna have to find somewhere to cool down. So what's the heat looking at? What's the heat like at the moment? Oh no, this is not good. Alright, I might need to take off my helmet. And... So see if that helps. Nope, it doesn't help at all. Or does it? Let's put it back on. Yeah, maybe there can be a skill that, you know, helps you to, you know, acclimatize to this new environment. Alright, so I think this is where I'll leave it, so I will continue in the next episode. So thank you for watching, and as always, if you could please like, comment, subscribe, and share. This is Fine Gaming Connoisseur, take care.